I want to say thank you very much to organizers at this. Oh, I'm sorry. Because at this conference we can see our old friends, the people close to Vadim, who was our young and genius colleague. And in any case, I think this conference is for people who is here is rather important. And the memory, of course, of Vadim is also very important for us. So today I want to discuss with you. Yesterday Samson said that all models, integrable models, can be derived from n equal to super symmetric gauge theory. Probably not all. So today I want to talk about some different dualities in integrable models. Why dualities in integrable models are important? The first, because the integrable models, besides some field theory definition, Lagrangian definition, have some other definition in terms of S matrix, which is rather simple object. If the theory is integrable, this S matrix is contains several functions of rapidity, and they have all information about the theory. All this function is enough to reconstruct all the theory. It gives us the possibility sometimes to show that the theory has some other dual representation. So in some sense, we can show that there is the maps between strong coupling to the weak coupling region, which gives us the possibility to study the theories in rather wide range of the coupling constant, even without integrability, and by different method as perturbation theory or semi-class, and so. But before I should say probably about sine-Lioville theory, which is also possess some property of duality. So sine-Lioville theory, I should say that some of results which I will talk about were derived together with Sasha and Alyosha Zanolochikov and also Enrico Onofri. So what is the sine-Lioville theory? It is some conformal field theory which is dual to the Witten black hole model, which is some coset model. It means that it's some parafermionic model. And it also describes some sigma model. And this sigma model is well known, cigar, Witten cigar. But even inside this model, there is some other duality. It is the duality between momentum and winding numbers of this theory. It is some other duality of this model to this such kind of surface, which is called trompet. It cannot be completely embedded to two-dimensional space, but even in three dimensions, but the visible part can be seen like. What was the conjecture which was done Sasha, Alyosha, and me many years ago, in 96, that this model is has the dual representation. And the theory has the same EV parameterize. It contains two parameters, A and B, which are related by one equation. So really we have one parameter in life. And the central charge can be written exactly as this one if we parameterize them by parameter k. It is the asymmetric central charge of this cosette model or the cigar model. Now, why it was based, at which real facts? So the theory is some parafermionic conformal field theory. These parafermions are non-compact SL2A parafermions, which can very simple representation in terms of two fields. And it is possible, easy to prove that these parafermions commute in the strong sense with these fields which form sine-Liouville perturbation of the which is the potential of sine-Liouville in our theory. It commutes in the strong sense. It means that it commutes locally, or that these fields are holomorphic fields after the perturbation. In principle, it gives the possibility to construct all W algebra, all local fields. This field is not local, but their operator product expansion contains the local fields which form infinite dimensional W algebra with infinite number of currents of spin 3, 4, and so on. For example, the spin 3 holomorphic current has this form. So now we want, the space of the primary fields here. It's easy to describe it in terms of the fields in sine-Liouville theory. It depends on two numbers, n and m. And n and m can be considered as one is the momentum number and the other as winding number. And momentum for cigar is conserved, and not winding number not conserved in principle. And here we introduce some dual field, which is related this simple relation with the field. Right? So we see that duality, for example, between cigar and trumpet, it is duality which change the number m and n. In trumpet, the winding number is conserved because we have no way to move cigar outside this trumpet. And another important characteristic of this theory, which is important for ultraviolet behavior of the theory or its perturbation, is to point function or the reflection amplitude. It means that if we take, for example, this field and we'll do the transformation of parameter alpha, which does not change all quantum numbers, it is the numbers related with the eigenvalues of W fields, then of course, after this transformation, only some numerical coefficient can appear for this field. And this numerical coefficient is rather interesting and important object can be calculated and was calculated. Then it was also calculated three-point functions in this theory. And really, it is enough from my point of view, if two theories have the same chiral symmetry algebra and two-point and three-point functions, it is enough to show that they are equivalent. But there are still a lot of other papers which contain this more and more rigorous proof. But we will stop about this point, and now we'll consider the possible integrable perturbation. To find the possible integral perturbation, it is to find different hierarchy, which how it we can do. We can consider the enveloping algebra of our W algebra and to see there some Cartan subalgebra or the subalgebra of integrable objects which can be called as integrals of motion. And this analysis show that at level three, it can be only one field, which can be the density of the conserved charge, of course, proportional to W3 field. And but it is possible to find another field which commute at level four, which commute with it. And of course, this object are defined up to the derivative, because only the integrals of this charge commute are the charges and commute. So it gives the possibility to show what is the perturbation of this. So the perturbation term in the Lagrangian, which appears, should also commute with these integrals of motion, not in the strong sense as it was before, but with charges, with integrals. So the first perturbation can be found, and the first hierarchy can be found, is generated by this perturbation. Then it is possible to find the second hierarchy. It will generated by perturbation. It will not have the spin three current, conserved current, but it will have spin four. And of course, all spin four are different from the first one, just because there's no other fields, just by the T square, regularized part of the stress energy tensor. So this theory contains more symmetry. It is symmetrical with respect to this transformation, and it corresponds to perturbation operator of this kind. And there is the third and probably the most interesting perturbation, which is symmetric with respect to phi and with respect of this exchange, and it corresponds to the sine-Lioville model, which perturbed by this operator. So there is, in principle, several perturbations, and what I want to say now, how the duality works in this integrable models. So let's consider the first one, probably the simplest one. So it is the perturbed Lagrangian. Here we can use the first duality which to prepare this Lagrangian for the perturbation theory.
And there is the usual Koliman-Mandelstam duality, because A and B, B is small, but A is not small.
The square, sum of square is equal, or different, is equal to 1/2. So to prepare our Lagrangian, we to do the first use duality of Mandelstam and Koliman, and to write this Lagrangian as the Lagrangian of Thiering model coupled with some exponential field and some other integrable with some field. Here, the second exponent appears as the counter term to work in the perturbation theory. So we have a small coupling. Now we can use the perturbation theory. When B is small, and this theory works very well, and we can calculate that the spectrum consists of two charged fermions, and there is also some particle with mass equal to m, which disappears from the spectrum because it is not stable with respect to decay. But also, what is interesting here, there exists some charge generated by the current of spin 3, and which does not permit the reflection in this theory. So this matrix is very trivial. It is just the phase. Then we know that the particle with mass 2m disappears from spectrum, so it should be at the appear in non-physical strip close to theta equal pi. And we can write the result in more or the less general form. We should do it is to compare to find the dependence of this delta on A. So it is possible if we consider the asymptotic of the ground state energy in the external field, and it is rather easy to do from Lagrangian, and we should calculate this value from Lagrangian and from the scattering theory and see that they are the same. And it is possible from Lagrangian, this asymptotics has this form. The all massive term we can take out, so it will be massless Thiering model interacting with the energy of this model is well known. It is this one. From other point of view, we can calculate it from the scattering theory, from a matrix approach, and here we should solve some integral equation, some thermodynamic beta ansatz equation. But in principle, it is enough to know not a lot about all this kitchen. So, for example, the same asymptotic can be calculated if we know the Fourier transform of our kernel at theta equals zero. So comparing these two values, we will find that this relation between delta and V and fix our scattering theory. And then let us see what happens when we move from small b to big B. And we will find that if we introduce parameter gamma, which is inverse power of B, this matrix again transform to this matrix, which is proportional to the trivial one at gamma equals zero. It means that there is some other weak coupling representation, the dual representation for this theory. To find the Lagrangian, we can calculate this energy in this limit. It is rather simple. And from other point of view, we will see that the theory now is completely bosonic. It is other we have some other also things which show us that the theory should be bosonic. For example, the behavior of this energy near threshold where A equal to M. So, and we see that now our theory is described by the action which contain the free bosons. And to support this, we can calculate this minimum and compare with S matrix result and to see that they coincide. And it means that we see that we have some interesting transformation. At small couplings, we have charged fermions. And in the weak coupling, we have the charged fermion. And in the strong coupling, we have the charged free bosons. And in my point of view, this is a little bit non-trivial, because we understand that strongly interacting bosons can be considered like fermions. But why strongly interacting fermions can become them bosons? It is a little bit, it looks a little bit strange. Okay, but another perturbation, I will not talk a lot about it. It also, in this case, we have a matrix which is less trivial. It should be the solution of some special equation. A matrix is restricted to be the solution of so-called Jahn-Baxter equation. And the solution is the only known solution with the symmetry U1 is this matrix of sine Gordon model up to multiplication to some CDD fact. And I will not discuss a lot of calculations, I only will say results. So really, it is the example where not minimal, but some CDD factor appears, not minimal solution of factorization equation. And it is possible to do again all possible calculation here and to find that Lagrangian, for this we should solve some integral equation. It can be solved by less trivial, it's some algebraic function of this, which is given in parametric way. And it exactly corresponds to this Lagrangian. The minimum of this Lagrangian, because it is bosonic one, we can use the classical theory. And the minimum gives us exactly the this Lagrangian. What is the interesting phenomenon which appears in this theory? In my opinion, a little bit strange is the following. Not only fermion-boson duality, but also that probably I forgot to say before that if you will treat at the beginning fermion-Lagrangian in terms of perturbation theory, you will find that it has two particles, charged particles, two charged fermions, and one boson, which can be considered as their bound state. But when we go to the strong coupling, this bound state disappears at some point. And from other point of view, we can consider going from small gamma to big gamma here. And for small gamma, this perturbation looks like attractive. And there is no any bound state. But for rather big gamma, due to sigma model nature of this term, we have the bound state, appears some bound state, even that the potential looks like attractive. So now I want to say probably the most interesting dualities in this perturbed model. The first is of them is known like the sausage model. So this model has nevertheless for the perturbation theory in B, this realization, Lagrangian regularization, which gives us possibility to find the asymmetrix. And the asymmetrix is now also restricted by Young-Baxter equation. And it coincides with the asymmetrix which we find with Sasha many years ago, and we didn't know which model it corresponds, and called it just the model factorized asymmetrix. But in 15 years, it found this model and married with it. It was the sausage model, which I will call later. So again, we can connect parameter lambda in in S matrix with parameter B in our scattering theory, in Lagrangian, and to see that everything is fine. But if we consider this S matrix for small lambda, when B is very big, we will see that this asymmetrix tends to the asymmetrix of a 3 sigma model. So it means that our theory is some U1 symmetrical deformation of our sigma model or 3 sigma model. And this deformation, to say about this deformation, we should say it is nice that Daniel said for me several words about this equation, so-called Ricci flow. So we can consider this Ricci flow with U1 symmetry and two-dimensional target space. And if we consider target space U1 theory, that there is really only one solution which is possessual property of attraction as it should. And it has the parameter nu. And nu is related with the effective curvature of our figure. And its dynamics of its dynamic in renormalization group time, it depends on one parameter u more or less, which is this product. And it looks in the beginning for small values of u, it looks like sphere, then it becomes a little bit like ellipse, and then it becomes like sausage. And really, if we cut the sausage by two parts, we will find that it is two Witten cigar which are glued together. And so this is from one point of view, we have the solution of factorization equation, from other, the solution of renormalization group equation, Ricci flow. So we should, now we want to prove that they correspond to the same model, which is the dual to the field theory, which we considered in the beginning when B goes to infinity. So there are many, of course, possibility. This exactly integrable kitchen knows many recipes, and I will not talk about them, but for example, if we introduce the external field, we will find that relation between parameter nu and parameter b or lambda in the theory of scattering theory. And then we can find some thermodynamic function like the energy in the one loop result, one loop approximation. How much time I have? Okay. Now we want to see what happens with our theory when we introduce, to see how this renormalization group equation works, we should introduce some scale. And if we consider our theory in the ultraviolet regime, for example, we can consider our theory at the circle. And if we consider this scaling variable like u nu multiplied by logarithm r, then in one loop, all our results should be exact. And if we consider now, for example, the central charge, which is related with the ground state energy of our theory of the circle, that it can be written that in the so-called mini superspace approximation, which is the approximation which is exact in the this limit, in the scaling limit, we can obtain some differential equation of the time. It is interesting that exactly the same equation appears later in the works of Grisha Perelman, and the zero eigenvalue of this operator play the role of some entropy which has the non-decreasing property. And but it is in some sense from the physics. It was first, it was written in our paper in 93, that its value is related with the central charge, which by the Zamolodchik of theorem should increase in when r goes to zero. So when scale goes to ultraviolet. And so this equation can be studied in this case in rather details. Really, everything can be expressed only in terms of parameters of parameter u. And the equation which appears, for example, for the ground state energy will correspond to the values of m equal to zero. And In this case, this value of epsilon zero of kappa, which is up to some constant, multiplicative constant, correspond to this central charge, will coincide with the most symmetric accessory coefficient about which Sasha talked yesterday.
It is when all fields have the same values of parameter alpha close to Q over 2.
So it can be calculated. We can find it asymptotic for small u and for large u. And just from this equation, it will be some Schrödinger equation in the potential. In some, in the small u, it will be have the memory of S of sphere, and all the values are very close to the spherical one. But when we will go to ultraviolet here, we will have the potential which will look like constant almost everywhere, but at the ends it will be some walls. And it is easy to calculate this asymptotics. And if we know also the reflection coefficient in this quantum mechanical probe and compare it with the reflection coefficient in which can be calculated, was calculated exactly in sine-Liouville theory, because this theory described the ultraviolet property of the theory from the left and from the right due to character of the perturbation, that we will derive the asymptotics when u is very big. And now there is this, we compare everything with, like, we can calculate with Lagrangian, which was in the beginning, with two-wall Lagrangian. We can calculate all these values more exactly with arbitrary precision. But there is possible also to calculate them from the equations, so-called thermodynamic Bethe-Ansatz equation, which are the couplet system of integral equations. It is not trivial, but now it is possible completely, exactly calculate more or less with arbitrary accuracy the value, this function corresponding to ground state energy, and it coincide with the corresponding limit which follows from the reflections amplitude and so. Here, I, for the people who knows this TBA technique, he has written the incidence diagram for this integral equation. The first one correspond to the sausage model. The second one correspond to some other model, which I will talk soon. And how much time I have?
You have another 15 minutes.
15 minutes, very well. So now I want to talk about some other model which can be derived from the sausage model by some analytical continuation. In the continuation in parameter u and parameter Why? In this case, we will have the metric, the sigma model with the metric, which will be singular. It will be singular, and it is defined only for y more than minus u. And but all, in any case, all geodesic distances on this surface are finite. It means that we can again apply this equation, this mini superspace equation, for analysis of this model. But how will look the dynamic of these surfaces? At the first case for the sausage model, we had the surgery of two cigars. Here we have the surgery of two other figures. It is the surgery of cigar with trumpet. And this figure looks like this. Now we can consider u like in infrared, in deep infrared, from deep infrared to deep ultraviolet. From u goes to minus infinity to going to the plus infinity. And at the beginning, when u is very negative, our figure looks like bell. Then it becomes more and more long, and so on. Unfortunately, in the presence of the dam, it is impossible to find some corresponding name for this model. But so it has no some name, but this dynamics is rather interesting. And if we consider the surgery in this case, it is possible to show that in the proper way the surgery is possible only when k number of our Lagrangian parameter of Lagrangian is equal to the integer. So there is some kind of, there is some kind of quantization of the coupling constant. And now we can find again to see this equation. It will change now a little bit, but it can, this eigenvalues can be expressed in some non-trivial way through the, at least the ground state can be expressed through the previous one. And when we have the point when u y is close to minus u, when our figure looks like the bell, it means that imaginary period goes to infinity. And in this limit, it is possible to solve this equation exactly and to find that this corresponding conformal field theory, we can obtain all spectrum of this conformal field theory and central charge from this equation. And the calculations show that the central charge and corresponding spectra of dimension correspond exactly to so-called Z-n parafermionic conformal field theories. These models describe the critical behavior of Zn analogies of Ising model, so the 10 Ising model. And here is almost exactly the spectrum of this model. Of course, we have in really in for exact value, it will have here n plus 2. But we, our approximation works in the case when n is rather big. So then it, if we consider now the perturbation theory near this exact solution, then perturbation will be in terms of modulus of elliptic function and really in this parameter, which in the quantum case, in exact case, it will have also some correction. But this, what is interesting, that this perturbation theory is convergent from in all region from S equal to 0 to S equal 1, which correspond to the ultraviolet region. It convergent, but for ground state is very, very slowly convergent. So in now in the infrared regime, we have the conformal field theory. What will be in the ultraviolet regime? In this case, we will have the potential of this type. So now our potential will be will look like the wall from one side, and from other side it will look like attractive potential. And in this case, we have some also new phenomenon. There appear some bound states in this equation. It means that in quantum case, there are some modulus of these surfaces related with the this attractive part of the potential, which appears for m more than 0. Here it is written the asymptotics when u goes to infinity. It is for ground state, it is the same as for the sausage case, but for non-ground state, they're different, a little bit different. And here we see the behavior of the level when m is order of 10, when you have rather many different levels. Here we move from infrared, from conformal field theory to the other conformal field theory corresponding to the, here is something like the Bell Zn parafermionic theory. Here we have some attractive part, but really we have the theory on the long cylinder with C equal 2. And we see that the levels, all levels, have the same monotonicity properties. All they decrease, or as it do, as they should, because it's minus. With minus, it is the central, more or less, related with central charge. And here we have all levels, discrete levels. Here they collect to the continuum spectrum, like it should be in a very long cylinder. So at the end, I want to say that now, if we calculate the right and left R matrix, they will be different. And really, if this R matrix can be derived
if we add from other side the perturbation of the following side. Here is again sine-Gordon perturbation, but with the dual field phi. So altogether, this potential will look like this for this model with singular metric. And but these two terms are mutually local. They are local with one respect other only if I square is integer over k equal 4 is integer. So we have another this coupling constant quantization. I can say several words more about some perturbation theory near this infrared point, but where it's possible to calculate more or less everything, but I don't think it is very important for people not working with integrable models. So and then probably some concluding remarks that the quantum field theory, which can be considered as the perturbation, integrable perturbation, can be massive and massless. And they have some rather interesting duality properties, like fermion duality and duality with sigma models. All this picture can be generalized, really. Sine-Lioville model can be related to the sine-Todde model, which also has some interesting properties of dualities. And the sausage model also can be generalized to probably the most general solution and exact solution of this equation, of Friedan equation, with three-dimensional target space. And it also, this theory is also dual to two-parametric family of integrable theories, which contain almost all known, almost all known integrable quantum field theories. Thank you.
I have a question, a naive question about this sigma model with the metric whose name shall not be named. if you could possibly turn to the transparency which where it is drawn. If you know what I'm talking about, the long one. No, here. Shall not be named. you say that the surgery, by the way, I somehow dislike the word surgery in this particular case.
No, it is not my, it is mathematician introduced this word.
In this particular case, I dislike it.
Okay.
Can you explain, is it possible to explain in simple words why, in this case, surgery demands nu to be 2 over integer?
The problem is that you should match two-wave function when you are very, very long. One, it is the wave function of trumpet, and another is the wave function of cigar. And this surgery can be done with some anesthesia. Really only when this value k is proportional to the integer.
It related that the number of, for example, windings and momentum number, they should be commensurate. And this appears only for integer values.
So that's what I thought. It's not possible to understand it without going to this anesthesy business.
Yes, but if we take some, if we consider the Lagrangian formulation, which correspond to this R matrix, which gives exactly the R matrix, which describes the all ultraviolet properties of this theory, the right one, and it will be not sausage, but some different from it when we have the duality between winding and momentum, then you will find that this theory also is well defined only for these values of.
No, I understand if you try to do t-duality with that, you necessarily come out to the conclusion that k must be integer. But from the point of view just of the metric itself, it's something like that.
But from other point of view, the theories flows in the infrared to the parafermionic theory. And this also, if n is not integer, the spectrum will not be finite. It will have infinite number of primary fields. It will not be the rational field theory. So the theory is really good when this parameter is integer.
Other questions?
What is known about the conformal blocks of sine-Lioville?
What is known? It is known something. In some sense, it can be related with expressed through the blocks of Liouville theory, some of them. But exactly something like AGT relation, it is not known at the moment, but it's still rather nice problem because it is the simplest model probably after Liouville theory. So sometimes it will be solved, I am sure.
If there are no other questions, let's thank all of you.